Welcome to the Noble Powertek Power Solutions Nationwide Series live broadcast from Watkins Glen International Raceway. I'm Ben Kilcrease. Rick Donathan, Andy Kessler will join me in a moment. They're both running a tad bit late tonight, but that's all right. I'm going to wing it here solo. Sam Taylor is your producer tonight. Tell you what, let's go ahead and run through a quick little pre-race show here before we get these cars crunk up, cranking, turning left and right. Let's take a look at the results and standings from last week. Phillip Willis, of course, came out with the win. He only led one lap, and that was the final lap. Kevin Graham led the most laps, 53 laps he led. And the points, Dave Washington leading over Kevin Graham, 12 points. Will Graham be able to close that gap in the final five or so races? We're going to have to wait and see. Mitch Lennon is third in points, and you have Phillip Willis and Brad Spiedel rounding out the top five. Let's go ahead and look at some track facts here at about Watkins Glen. It's right at 2.5 miles. We're going to be turning 11 times tonight in the 35 laps that we run. Got to watch out for that bus stop on the back stretch, or what we consider the back stretch. And it's a little right, then left, and left, and right. A little quick little in and out there. And all around the track, you have 6 to 10 degrees of banking, which gives you a little bit of lean on here and there, but not too much. So your drivers won't be able to get too carried away. Last but not least, before we get ready to crank them up, let's take a look at Andy's keys to the race. Qualifying and track position will be a huge factor in tonight's event because it's so hard to pass here. That's the next point. They're passing zones. There's only a few on this track. And you got to be real careful in those certain few. And last but not least, it's a road course. Not too many. Don't get too many breaks if you mess up. So you got to be smooth here at Watkins Glen. But we're getting ready to crank up the cars here at Watkins Glen, the Noble Powertek Power Solutions Nationwide Series. We are going to be right back after this short commercial break. On behalf of iRacing.com, Motorsport Simulations, Noble TV, Noble Motorsports, and Powertek Power Solutions for sponsoring the Nationwide Series here tonight. We are at Watkins Glen International Raceway. I'm Ben Kilcrease, Andy Kessler. Join me in the booth right now. Rick Donaldson's going to be up here in just a little bit. He's running a tad bit late tonight. Sam Taylor is doing the producing, getting the picture that you see to you, and we're going to want to go ahead and send out a notice that our producer Sam is running on some new graphics card, new video card tonight, so we will go ahead and extend an apology if anything does happen throughout the night. But Andy, we're at Watkins Glen. We're going to be turning right and left this weekend.
Yeah, we are, Ben, but mostly right-hand turns at this track. It's almost, one would say for a road course, it's almost going backwards. We didn't get to talk about that in a pre-race show, but it's definitely a little bit different than, say, Sonoma in the Cup Series. But I definitely like this track better. It's a lot faster. It shows a lot more speed and a lot more technical as far as speed-wise. But where Sonoma has a lot more elevation and changes like that to it. So I'm looking forward to this. This is what it's all about.
Gonna be fun. The Cup Series visited just a few weeks back. They put on a dandy of a show. But tell you what, let's go ahead and run them through the starting lineup tonight. Starting on the pole, blowing the field away by over half a second, Dylan Jones puts that number 11 on the pole, but to his outside, or to his left side, I'll say, TJ Graves second.
You got Kevin Graham there along with Dave Washington rounding out the row number two.
Brad Spydale rounds out top five, and to his left side, James Ross in the 14.
I think I fogged up my binoculars, man. I can't see the numbers.
No problem. I'll have to get mine out here. James Gagne going to be in the 05. Then it's Mitch Lennon to his outside. And his row number four. Row number five, Eric Dallariva in the 74. Rounding out the top 10, 13 is William Roberts. Roy Carpenter in the 95 rolls off 11th. And Brian Lambert, 12th. Marcus Miller is 13th. Brian Terry, 14th in the 92. Rodney Kramer. In the 6th car, rolls off 15th, Stephane Brunel, 16th, in the 20. 75, Ronald Henry, rolls off 17th, 24, Chad Osborne to his outside in 18th. Brian Neff, 60 car, 19th. Robert Lawson, 45, he rolls off 20th. Rounding out the field and starting shotgun on the field, in the number 96 is Andy Carpenter. We are in 4-1 today. 35 laps, a set distance. Last week at Michigan, these guys put on a heck of a show. One of the best we've seen in quite a while. And we expect no less than that tonight. Field rounds corner number 10, coming through 11. The pace car is going to get ready to pull down onto pit road. Usually he turns left, but tonight he's turns right. Dylan Jones, TJ Graves on the front row. We're racing at Watkins Glen.
Dylan French. Real impressed with that 43 car there, Ben. He's been coming on strong here in the Nationwide Series the last few weeks, and a good solid run last week. Sits sixth in points right now, and got that second position there in qualifying. So good job by TJ so far.
I was talking to TJ a little bit earlier today. He said, man, I don't know how I'm going to do tonight. But he comes out, puts the car runner-up position, starts off second. So a good run, or a good qualifying effort for TJ Graves. But Dylan Jones, like I said, out qualifying the field by over half a second. He has really got this thing dialed in tonight at Watkins Glen. Clean so far on the first lap.
Yeah, he does have it dialed in so far, Ben, but you also want to take note that some of these road courses like this, it's all about qualifying, usually depending on how you do as far as dodging any wrecks or things like that, but typically you can start in the top 10, you have a pretty good chance to finish there or contending for the win, so what TJ did and Dave Washington and, of course, Dylan Jones, that's exactly what you need to do.
Good battle for fifth. James Ross, Brad Spydell. They're side by side as we complete lap one. Now diving down into corner number one. Then behind them we have Mitch Lennon and Eric Dallariva. They're going at it. James Gagne now gets under Lennon. Lennon really got off of turn number one, not to the best of his abilities. Go ahead and update you, Robert Lawson. has pulled up behind the wall. He's called it quits tonight. Clean through the bus stop for all the leaders, but pretty sideways going through there. Andy, is real treacherous, that bus stop. That's such a tight part of the track. You know, you're coming from 150 mile an hour, getting down to, I don't even know, 40 or so mile an hour to get that turn down there. It's real tough. Kind of like Martinsville, going at high rate speeds and then turning very sharp around the corners there. That's what we can kind of compare it to.
It is, but it's also a real high speed part of the course, and you can actually gain a lot of time on your competitors through that series of turns there in the bus stop. And if you can really hit it just right, you can almost make it through there with very little braking. So it's all about getting your timing right and your braking points and actually when to turn in, because we've seen guys in the past there turn a little bit too early and clip that guardrail on entry. Washington's leading the points right now, Ben, and it looks like a pretty good battle. He's got about a 12-point lead over second place Kevin Graham, so it's still anyone's game. A lot of guys are real close in the point battle so far.
Graham right behind Washington, trying to make up as much as he can in this race. He's got to get the move on if he wants to keep Washington within his reach, I should say.
Yeah, and with only five races to go, Ben, including tonight's race, not much time to get it done. We talked about it the other night with the trucks only having three races to go, and Philip Willis really dominated. Well, didn't dominate, but he pulled out the win in the trucks there as Kevin Graham goes a little wide on the corner there a second ago. But, they got plenty of time to make up this ground. Only 25 back to Mitch Lennon and 37 to Philip Willis there in fourth, and the way he's been coming on the last week there, winning last week, of course, and then winning the trucks there. He's just had a real good week so far for Noble.
Ronald Hendry in the 75 car, he's was pointed wrong way down in corner number 11, or between 10 and 11. He's got some damage to that 75 car, but pretty much everyone else has been pretty clean so far here in the early going.
It's all about patience, getting your rhythm down, getting in the groove. You don't have a lot of time, only 35 lap race here, so you don't have much time. You really got kind of a sense of urgency, but at the same time, you don't want to push the issue because, like I said, if you qualify good, man, you don't want to make it some mistake, costly mistake that finds you in the back, because then you're going to have a real hard time coming back through the field here before this thing's over.
Field pretty much spread out. Close battle, or one of the closest, for seventh between James Ross and James Gagne. Andy Carpenter has been making his way up the field. He started 21st. He's 15th. He's looking good in the early going. Looking out of the rear end of James Ross. James Gagne right behind him in the 05. This is a battle for 7. Then right behind him you have Lennon and William Roberts getting ready to do battle.
Yeah, Ben, you talk about a diverse, field, I guess you could say. We're only coming up on 5 laps complete in this race here. And these guys are, already 12 seconds back and 13 seconds back, and so it doesn't take long to get behind here at a road course.
Yep, you're setting your keys in the race. Qualifying and track position, a huge thing, and right now it's that is being proved. You really have to get some good. You got to have a good qualifying run to be successful here, and not have to worry about passing a bunch of cars. Michelin and William Robertson, that's for ninth. They got pretty close down in one and two. They're coming into two off of one. On board with William Robertson. You see, Andy, he uses the bus stop to his advantage, closed up real close to the rear end of Michelin right there.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about. If you can really time it just right, you can really make up a lot of time through that little section, and he just did. You saw it right there. Some guys are real good at it, but then, you know, they struggle maybe somewhere else on the road course, and it costs them the time that they made up in that. So that's why another one of the keys was being smooth, and you really got to be smooth in every single corner if you really want to make some head ground on any of these guys.
Completing lap number six here at Watkins Glen, Dylan Jones still leads, and look up here for seventh, James Gagne all over the rear bumper of series sponsor James Ross. Down the back straightaway, does Gagne look low? Does he try and step out? Does he try and outbreak him? Not going to do it this time, but he does. He's up to the rear bumper. Through the bus stop we go. Now we're going to head out onto the carousel, we like to call it. Long sweeping turn here. Oh, Brad Spidell off the track. He was running fifth. Oh, my. Oh, he was closing up on the rear end of Kevin Graham. That was about to be a battle shaping up for fourth. And Spidell, Graham braked a little bit earlier than Spidell thought he was. Spidell locked up the tires and away she went. Spidell drops back to 13th. Out up front, Dylan Jones setting the pace tonight. He is really putting the whooping on these guys.
Hey, watch that. What happened to Brad Spidell there, Ben? And unfortunate thing, but that just shows how tight this course is. And
lead around.
Big trouble there for Dylan Jones there, Ben. Going through turn number 10, coming off of there, basically where Brad Spidell had his issues. Smacked that tire barrier. He's got a lot of damage to that left side of the car there, and I don't know how much it actually knocked the toe out or if it did at all, but not good for that leader right there.
It was heavy contact. Doesn't look like it hurt him too much, but in the long run, it could be catastrophic for Dylan Jones. That was one of your keys. Gotta be smooth to win here at Watkins Glen, and just a slight little tap on the throttle a little bit quicker than you're used to can really upset the car and put you in that sort of situation. He did hit it square enough, though. He might have done that on purpose, trying to hit it square as he could so it didn't do as much damage as he would have hit it with one of the corners, but there's definitely damage to that number 11.
Yeah, you can't even read the number off the side of it, but he's able to stay ahead of TJ, and it looks like he didn't really lose that much time to TJ even through that exchange. Like you said, he looked like he hit it pretty hard, but he hit it pretty flat too, so like you said, there might not be any suspension damage. I mean, obviously he probably would have known by now anyway, going through all these corners, but yeah, I think he dodged a bullet there for now.
He could have looped that thing all the way around, come back up in front of Graves and collected 2-3 cars right there, but good thing that did not happen. Woo, Graham gets it loose off of one. Battle back here for what is now seventh. William Roberts trying to get around James Ross. Gagne got around Ross. Now Roberts trying to make his way around him, and Roberts having some connection issues. That made it a little bit hairy going up there through the S's right there. Got one driver down on pit road, Chad Osborne. Changing some tires. I don't know if that's early strategy or if he might have looped it around, got some dirt on the tires, maybe a flat spotted one. Looking back up here at Dylan Jones, Andy, he's actually starting to pull back away from TJ Graves, so I don't think the damage that he sustained is too crucial because he's already back out to a 3.5 second lead.
Yeah, you never know, Ben. Sometimes it works in weird ways that it actually might help the car, make it drive better for him.
Old trick I learned from, I can't even remember the guy's name now. Car's a little bit out of tow. Or if it's a little bit loose, you can go up and smack the wall just a little bit in the center of the corner on an oval. It'll tighten it up. But I don't know. Like I said, it could have been to his advantage right there. Could have helped him. Rodney Kramer off the track in front of Jones. He's going to get it turned around. Hang on. Rodney Kramer's at the inside of the track. He's down on the grass. Brian Neff has had some technical difficulties. He has pulled up behind the wall for the time being. We were actually in a race with Brian Neff last night. I wrecked him about 3 or 4 times. A little test session or a fun race. Yeah. Rick threw up last night. They also told us that his son and a bunch of his buddies over at the University of Toledo watch these races. So hi, hello to the University of Toledo. Doritos. He also said that they have a jug of sweet tea. That, in the middle of them, they all take a swig of sweet tea or something like that.
I think it might be a little something different than that, Ben. Maybe an aluminum container with a tap on it, but we'll just stick with that. But yeah, man, awesome to hear those guys like watching these races, and of course we like having them watch these races, and we try to make them somewhat interesting.
A little bit hard. You're probably sitting there watching it tonight and saying, boy, these guys have absolutely no idea what they're talking about. Well, you're right. We're oval guys. We don't do the road stuff too much, but when we do, we try and make it as exciting as we can. I think we do a pretty good job.
Hold on, I'm doing a keg stand.
Also want to mention, while we have a little break in the action, want to thank all of you fans of ours out there. We have reached over 20,000 views on YouTube and Twitch alone. So at the beginning of this year, I sat down with all my guys in January and I said, I want to get at least 20,000 this year. And we've already surpassed that in the month of March. So thank all of you fans. That's not from us watching, and that's from you guys watching. If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't have that number. So thank you for getting us 20,000 views on all of our YouTube and Twitch there.
Yeah, I know it's definitely not me, Ben. I hate watching myself. I mean, listening to myself. So, yeah, it's definitely not me watching them. So, yeah, hats off to all those everybody that tunes in and checks out the replays and stuff like that. Because that's why we like doing this. We enjoy to do it. So it's nice to see that other people enjoy watching it.
Good battle going on for second. TJ Graves under pressure from Dave Washington. Dave Washington points leader right now. Graves sitting in sixth.
That's part of my thing there, Ben. You know, he qualified second. Look where he's running. He's been up there the whole race. You know, sometimes you fall back a couple spots here or there, but when you qualify that well, pending any major issues or anything like that, you expect a top five finish.
Ooh, Graves did not get off of the S's that time, and here comes Washington looking to the inside. Graves is going to try to... Ooh, Graves gets it sideways. They almost touch. Here comes Kevin Graham. They're side by side still. Graham now trying to make it around TJ Graves. That got a little bit hairy.
It did, but awesome car control by TJ there. Easily could have looped it around there. I know if that was me, I would have. So, heck of a job he did right there, keeping that thing straight.
TJ is coming off of a big win last night in the Noble SK Modified Series over there. So he's trying to back it up two wins in a row, trying to get two wins in 5 days like old Philip Willis did. But now he's coming down pit road. I think it's time for a new set of tires. Dylan Jones is down as well. The only person staying out so far, Eric Dallariva. Oh, look out, Brian Terry was just off in the bus stop as well. All right, so let's see what all, who's going to take what, where are they going to take them? Oh, did Kevin Graham miss his pit stall? Oh, my, Andy, a huge development. Kevin Graham has missed his pit stall.
Yeah, that's not a good thing, especially here on a road course, because he just lost a ton of time and he's still going to have to come back around and in. So, yeah, that's unfortunate. We're going to have to see where it shakes out and where he ends up being placed here. But that also might change your strategy a little bit. Maybe he only takes two tires, but which isn't the best thing to do on a road course. So we'll have to see what happens here as he comes back around again. But that's a wicked unfortunate thing here at the road course.
Yeah, Pete probably lost at least about a half a lap. Half a track or so right there. Jones working through some lap traffic. You saw him get around Brian Neff. Neff is back out on the track. He's running 18th right now. Rodney Kramer. Jones just gets by Kramer there. Next person is going to be Roy Carpenter. Neff still looking a little slow. They might have not have got all the kinks worked out. Eric Dallariva down pit road. He is exiting now. I think Dallariva, he might have something for Jones. If Jones makes a small mistake, he's coming out right now. And after this round of pit stops, Eric Dallariva might be scored as second. I do believe he is going to be.
It's amazing to think that that one extra lap would make him up that much time. So, heck of a job by him and his crew chief there.
We'll have to wait and see. We'll get you an updated lineup here in just a moment. All in all, though, a clean race. Had a few off tracks here, a few little brushes with the wall, but not too many major accidents. We haven't had any cars flying over the catch fence or anything, so it's been a pretty fairly clean race so far here at Glen. Coming around, got 20 laps to go here in this one. Go ahead and run you through how the lineup is right now. First is Dylan Jones. He's still out in the lead. Then we have Eric Dallariva, Dave Washington, TJ Graves, Kevin Graham. Hang on. William Roberts, Brad Spiedel, Kevin Graham, 8th. Roy Carpenter, 9th. Andy Carpenter, 10th. And we'll run you through those again because it was still updating as I was saying that, so I apologize. If you're wondering, our scoring up here in the tower is different than the scoring you would see on your screen or whatnot. We have to wait, kind of like on a short track, Andy, up here in the booth, we have to wait until the cars actually pass the start-finish line for the information to be given to us on where the cars are at on the track. That's why we get confused sometimes.
Yeah, I blame it on the system, too. It's just easier.
Yeah, it's not us. It's the system.
Yeah, it's not a big deal. We all know where everybody is.
All right, let's try this again. Dylan Jones is your leader. We do know that much. Eric Dalariva sits second. Then it's Dave Washington, TJ Graves, William Roberts just jumped up to fifth. James Ross is sixth. Kevin Graham is sixth. Excuse me. Mitch Lennon. Then it's going to be James Ross, Brad Spiedel, Andy Carpenter rounds out the top ten. And it's Brian Terry, 11th. Rory Carpenter, Lambert, Brunel, Miller, Kramer, Gagne, Neff, Osborne, Hendry, and Lawson rounds out the rest of the field. Trying to look all throughout the field. Not too many close battles going on. Everyone pretty much spread out. Might have a battle heating up here in the next few laps or so for third. Graves kind of been closing the gap on Dave Washington over the past few or so laps.
He had that one little slip up there going through the S's. Couple laps there before the pit stops there and allowed Dave to get around him, and since then he's been right behind him following his.
You'll hear me on the whisper.
Dylan Jones continues to dominate here at Watkins Glen. Working on completing lap number 20, Dylan Jones just begun lap 20, Eric Dalariva. Now about 8.5 seconds behind him, Jones has had the car to beat. We are going to be right back here for the Noble Powertek Power Solutions Nationwide Series at Watkins Glen. We're back here at Noble TV. Watkins Glen is where we are doing battle tonight. Dylan Jones is out in front of the field by over 8 seconds. Closest competitor, Eric Dalariva, he's running second. Dave Washington and his TJ Graves and Kevin Graham rounds out the top five.
I think the big winner on that one, Ben, was Kevin Graham not losing too many positions after that mistake there on pit road.
He definitely got real lucky there. Roy Carpenter was off the track right in front of Eric Dalla-Riva. That got a little bit hairy for a little bit right there. Dylan Jones, though, just continuing to step away. He is dominating here in the early going. It's not really too early now. It's about over halfway through the race, so. Jones has had the car to beat, even with that smack with the wall over in the first 10 or so laps. Update you on some people that pulled it behind the wall. Chad Osborne, he is done for the night, as well as James Gagne. Really too much going on the track. The whole field spread out. A bunch of lap traffic for your leader, Jones. It's about the only passing that's occurring right now. Do have a battle, or did have a battle for third. Dave Washington coming down pit road. Here we go, Andy pit stop, second round. Who's going to gain the most right here?
Yeah, this is the money stop right here, Ben. No mistakes. Got to get all you can get there on pit road. Get your tires, get your fuel, and maybe just fuel only with some of these guys. There's only about 12 laps to go here, so it's going to be interesting to see some of the strategy play. And it looks like Dave Washington is fuel only, so strategy already playing out for some of these guys.
Trouble TJ Graves around at a bus stop. He didn't hit anything. He was trying to get around the lap traffic of Brian Terry. Not going to put it fault anybody right there. Just looks like a racing incident. The bus stop is tight enough for one car as it is, but when you try and fit two in there, that's what will happen. I want to give a shout out to Philip Willis. He's not racing here tonight, but he is watching. Willis texted me earlier, said, "Man, I wish I could be down there racing." Philip, we miss you, and hopefully you'll be back here next week, Willis. DJ Graves getting his service done. Dylan Jones has yet to pit. And Eric Dalla-Riva still has to come down pit road as well. While we have a moment, Noble Motorsports and Team Explosion TV come together this season to form Noble TV. You can like Team Explosion TV on Facebook. Just search Team Explosion TV, or you can follow them on Twitter at Team Explosion TV. Check out the website, TeamExplosionTV.com. Subscribe on YouTube and follow on Twitch. Speaking of Team Explosion TV, Andy, we've made an agreement with the OIL Racing League. They're going to be back on Sunday nights for their whole season of their nationwide series. They always put on a good show over there.
Yeah, they do, Ben. We just got finished with that season here last week. They're down at Homestead and crowned a new champion in the series, Dave Duberly. So good to see that, but we'll see how things go and see if he can defend his title. Sounds like they got a few new guys there are going to start this week, too, in their season opener at Daytona. So looking forward to that, and looking forward to, obviously, the rest of all the races we still got here with Noble, and three big series coming down to the end here with everything close in points.
Good evening, guys. Sorry I'm late. They wouldn't let me in the pit there just a few minutes ago, but glad to be here. Been watching a little bit of the race, running behind in traffic, but hey, I'm here.
Hey, glad to have you, Rick.
Hey, Rick, I was going to say, I didn't know the traffic that you were talking about meant the line at the hot dog aisle.
By the way, yours is over there. You wanted two all the way right.
Right. Shh, quiet.
Tell you what, guys, been watching Dylan Jones, and, man, I tell you, he's getting around this track like a sewing machine that's just been just put together, just running just fine and dandy. Looking really good out there.
He has been the talk of the night. He's been putting a clinic on these guys. He has over a 12.5-second lead right now. He is the absolute car to beat right now.
Like the next guy in place there, Kevin Graham, showing to be in seventh. I heard you say a little earlier the way the scoring is going, probably the second place guy must be in the pit. Can't find him on the track.
Second place is going to be Eric Dalariva. He's out there running. He still has yet to make his pit stop, so we're going to see his pit stop coming within the next few laps. Dave Washington has already made his pit stop. Washington is being scored third. The next person behind him, Mitch Lennon and Brad Spiedel, they round out the top five. Like I said, Jones and Eric Dalariva have yet to make their pit stops here for the final time.
Tell you what, Ben, I've never done a broadcast on a road course like this, so when we start talking about what corners they're in and so forth, I am just completely lost here today, buddy.
We're all lost. Yeah, like I mentioned earlier, people watching probably, man, these guys have absolutely no idea what they're talking about, and they're right. We're awful guys, but we can put on a show on the road. We do our best. Dylan Jones going to stay out this time. Tell you what, Sam, let's ride on board for Dylan Jones for one lap. Let's just go silent up here in the booth, and let's let Jones show you how it's done here at Watkins Glen. That is how you do it at Watkins Glen, and that is the reason he has a 14-second lead over Eric Dalariva, working on lap number 29 right now, closing in on that 5-lap-to-go mark.
Tell you what, taking a look right now at Eric Dalariva, I tell you, he's no joke to play around with either. He's had, so far, a pretty good, strong season. Big contender at some of the tracks there, but I understand that Eric Dalariva is pretty good at these road course tracks as well through the mobile racing community. A lot of people talked about a practice race that they had earlier. Eric Dalariva got out and led that thing, I believe, the whole race. Done very well in it.
I'm not mistaken, Eric Dalariva actually won the cup race.
Hey,
a few weeks back.
Dominating fashion, too. Sort of like what Dylan Jones is doing tonight.
Ronald Henry around in the bus stop. Sorry to cut you off there, Rick.
Yep, that's what I saw. I didn't know what we call it, the bus stop. I didn't know that.
Yep, that's the bus stop, interloop. The hard part, if you like, whatever you want to say. Dylan Jones, though, coming down pit road. This is going to be the last time we will see that number 11 hit pit road. And we'll have to see how good he does on his pit stop here. This could be the money breaker.
Question's
money maker
be,
or the backbreaker, as I like to say.
Question is going to be, is Eric Dallarive going to go into pits? And it doesn't look like he does. So is he going to try to stretch this thing out without going into the pit?
I was just about to wonder here. I was wondering that myself. He might be trying to save gas. Making it only on one stop, that's a little bit iffy, but Jones, he's already headed back out. So we'll have to see here. It's going to get interesting.
You have to remember, though, too, Ben, Eric did stay out longer than anybody else did, too. So if he's going to be able to make, he's probably the only one because he stayed out and was able to stretch that first run.
If he's able to make it, he has definitely showed us how pit strategy is supposed to work. This time by, Eric Dallarive will see the five lap to go signal.
That's what I was about to say there, Ben, is pit strategy. He may have just clinched it right there as long as he's got enough fuel to get the distance. I know that Dylan Jones is going to be coming hard, though. Eric Dallarive looks like he's going into the pits.
He's coming down pit road, but he might just be able to take a splash and go right here. We're going to have to wait and see. Got to come down that pit road at 45 mile an hour, real slow pace.
Dylan Jones on the straightaway.
Now Dylan Jones back to the lead, so it doesn't look like Eric Dallarive is going to inherit the lead after that one. Update you on another driver that's pulled it behind the wall, Brian Terry. Dave Washington actually going to get out ahead of Eric Dallarive right here, so that might bump up Dallarive, or might bump up Washington to second, Dallarive back to third.
Dallarive just getting fuel, no tires he took. So definitely going to help him there on the pit. Now, the question is how old are the tires that he has on there, and is he going to have enough ump to maybe try to catch Dylan?
Dylan Jones, the class of the field here tonight. He's going to come off of corner number 11 this time by. It's going to be four laps to go.
I believe Eric Dallarive just went into corner number 10 here, right before the 11. If I understand how we're counting these corners here, Ben.
Oh, trouble on the front straightaway. Sorry to cut you off there, Rick. Ronald Henry in the wall again. He has not had a good night here at Watkins Glen.
Wow, looks like he may have just blew the engine.
Yeah, there will be no rehabilitating that number 75 machine. Update you on who's where. Dylan Jones just now heading into the carousel. Dave Washington just now entering the back stretch. Now Eric Dallarive is coming off the back stretch.
Eric Dallarive and Brian Lambert, they're going in side by side in the bus stop, I guess you could say. Of course, Eric Dallarive just got passing pretty easy, took the corners very well. Looks like he's just, it doesn't look like he's pushing the car that hard.
Hey, you gotta think, though, he is on those older tires, so he's not going to be able to push it as hard as, say, Washington or Graham or somebody that took all tires on that last round of pit stops. Ooh, Jones getting a little bit loose up to the S's right there. He's got to be careful here in the final three or so laps. And you got to think, even if Jones ran into lap traffic right now, he's still got an 18 or so second lead. So Jones pretty much has this thing wrapped up. He just has to avoid looping it around or making hard contact with anything, and he's gonna end up in victory lane tonight.
Easy there, Ben. You're about to jinx him now.
Don't
You want to hear a bad interview, that'd be that one at the end of the race.
Oh, man.
I'm just saying, you got to take it easy. This time by, off of corner number 11, Dylan Jones will see the popsicle sticks at the flag stand. Two laps to go here at Watkins Glen.
Ooh, got a little sideways there. Maybe got into the gas a little much, or maybe the tires are just giving away there for Dylan Jones. The way he hit that apron, Carter, like, got a little sideways coming out of that first turn.
Boy, I think if I was down there driving, it'd be sideways in the wall, upside down. So I gotta give him credit to be able to drive this thing here.
You know, now since I can say I raced beside you before now, Ben, you're right. Hey, come on. And we're not even going to talk about Andy.
Yeah, we're not even going to talk about Andy after last night's restart. Oh, dear.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, we had a talk about that at the beginning of the show. It was a fun night last night.
Absolutely. And I tell you what, for the viewers out there, that's what NobleMotorsport.com is all about. Having fun, getting to know some of the guys, and I tell you, some of these guys I've been around now, it's like I've known them for a long time.
Oh, yeah, good group of guys over at Noble. The TSCV guys like to come out and hang out every once in a while. White flag, though, in the air for Dylan Jones. He has had the car to beat all night long.
Tell you what, taking a look at Eric Dallariva coming out on the front stretch, watched and just crossing over the start-finish line. Now the question's going to be, will Eric Dallariva be able to catch Washington?
I don't know. That's going to be Washington's definitely going to have to make a mistake for Dallariva to have anything for him. But you never know. You can't say anything until the race is over. Jones. Getting out of the bus stop real good, heading through the carousel. He has one lap car ahead of him. That's Andy Carpenter. I don't think he's going to be a factor in this one. Carpenter, well, I thought he was going to pull over and let him go. Don't think Jones is going to catch him through corner number 10.
Washington gets through the bus stop very well, in and out, and then he gets into the next corner. Very smooth. Got a little sideways coming out of that corner there, but looking good. Eric Dallariva is coming on strong, though, but he may run out of time.
Dylan Jones wins at Watkins Glen.
Washington lining up, coming around for the last turn. That way he can take second place finish here at Watkins Glen, and he's going to take the second place finish.
Washington second. Here comes Eric Dallariva off of corner number 11. Dallariva going to round out the podium here in the Finger Lakes region of New York. Kevin Graham, going to be a good finish for that number 4 car. He's going to finish in the 4th position. Remember, he was sideways one time in this race early on.
Yeah, missed his pit stall, did a whole bunch of things. To come out with a top 4, that's a pretty good feat for him.
Yo, we got in the 2 car. I believe it was Mitch Lennon and Brad Spidell. Coming out of the last corner there, fighting for position. We're going to see who gets that position.
Here comes Graves flying around the outside. Graves says, yeah, I'll take those.
Graves,
so Graves gets 6th, and wow. Boy, did that get exciting. William Roberts looked like he was out of gas, and that's might have what triggered all that. Spidell got in the Mitch Lennon. Spidell came to a stop. Lennon rolled back out in front of him, and then Graves just comes bonsaiing around the outside. He's almost driving to the grass. He picks up 2nd. 6th. Man, that got exciting. And look at Dylan Jones. Dylan Jones burning him down. And he deserves to burn him down after that victory. He put a clinic on the field.
Did a good job driving today. Oh, Holly Farms.
Glen.
Yeah, I'm looking at the old Holly Farms cars. What I'm seeing, is that what you're seeing, Ben?
That is. Tell you what, we're going to take a moment to catch our breath here, get work down the pit road. We're going to head to a quick commercial break, but after this, we'll have driver interviews and we'll talk to Dylan Jones. We're back here at Watkins Glen International Raceway after seeing a domination here by Dylan Jones. I guess you could call it that. But right now we're going to talk to a few of the drivers, and I hear that Rick Donathan has caught up with third place finisher Dave Washington. Rick?
Well, I believe that's going to be second place finisher Dave Washington is what I'm seeing here. Dave, how do you feel?
Tonight I feel fantastic. It was an awesome race. Class D driver finishing second. I'm ecstatic.
Well, I tell you what, take me back to the last few laps there. Knowing that Eric Dallariva was coming, he was coming pretty strong. Didn't know that he was going to have enough rubber left on those tires. Now, how was your tires in the last three laps there?
My tires were, left sides were shot. Right sides weren't bad. I just kept it straight, you know, came out of the corner straight, just easy on the gas, and just tried not to make any mistakes.
I tell you what, did a good job driving out there this evening. Now, if we had maybe five more laps, do you think you'd had enough juice to maybe catch Dylan Jones?
No, he was too fast. I didn't have anything for him. I was very happy when I got into second, and I knew Eric, they had to pit. I know there's no chance of catching Dylan, but Eric, I figured I had a chance with at least get to his bumper, but I didn't realize it's going to pass him.
Fantastic. Anybody out there you want to thank?
Yeah, thank Powertek Power Solutions, Team Elite, Noble, TSTV guys, Noble, all the drivers. It's a great series.
Fantastic. Well, I tell you what, guys, there you hear it from second place finisher David Washington coming in with a strong second place. I'm going to pass the mic on up to Andy. I believe he's with our third place finisher, Eric Dallariva.
That's right. I'm here. I got Eric standing right next to me. And Eric, you won here a few weeks ago in the Cup Series, and then you backed it up with a third place finish tonight. How was the car tonight for you?
Car was pretty good. I guess messed up in qualifying. I really thought I'd put down a good lap, and it was not what I thought it was, and kind of put us back there mid-pack, and I knew I'd have to kind of make a bit of a strategy call to get on up there, and so we just didn't take any tires on the first pit stop, and it obviously worked out. We got ourselves a good finish.
Yeah, you did. I talked about it a lot at a track like this, that qualifying and track position is huge, because With the iRacing set, you don't get full course caution, so there's no chance to actually catch back up to somebody besides running them down. Everyone's pretty consistently about the same kind of lap times here. So to actually catch someone and pass someone is really difficult. You're either going to do it on the pits or with strategy, or you're going to have to just out-qualify them and be up front and be able to stay up front the whole race. And, I mean, for qualifying ninth and coming in to finish third, I would say that's a huge almost win, I guess I should say.
Yeah, like I said, I'm really happy with it considering where we started. I also kind of screwed that last pit stop up. I took two tires and I didn't want to take any there. So that might have slowed us up a bit and allowed Dave to get by. But you're absolutely right. Starting ninth, coming home third, we've had a tough couple weeks since we won in the A Cup at Watkins Glen. So hopefully a good finish here will kind of get things turned around.
That's good, Eric. And who got you here tonight?
Just got to thank God and got to thank all you guys up here in the booth. And I just got to thank Noble Motorsports for letting us go racing on a road course. I like them a lot and get pretty excited whenever we get to run one. So, and thank the drivers too. It was a really good race. Everyone did a really good job tonight.
Awesome job. Thanks a lot, Eric. And Ben, that's one guy that wouldn't mind a full season of road courses, but he does get his wish. He gets a couple of them every season. But here you're down in Victory Lane right now.
I'm pretty sure right now Dylan Jones would like a few more in the schedule as well. First of all, Dylan, for I want to apologize for Dave Washington saying he finished third. He actually finished second, and Dollar Evil was third. But let's talk to Mr. Jones here. Dylan, you had the car to beat. Tell us how you did it.
Yeah, the car was real good tonight. Always run good here at those road courses. Always do good practicing and qualifying, but I have a little bit of trouble finishing them out here. So happy to finally get one tonight.
Dylan, in the first part of the race, you got sideways off of corner number 10 and smacked the tire barrier. You didn't do too much damage to the car, but how bad did that scare you?
That corner gets me every time. If I'm going to wreck, it's going to be in that corner. I was worried that I was going to knock the toe out there. Glad it wasn't too bad.
Sounds great. Yeah, hit the wall, didn't get too much damage. But you came home in Victory Lane, a dominating performance. Who do you want to thank for getting you here?
Just want to thank everyone at Noble putting this on. It's always fun. You guys at TSTV and all the drivers for having a good, clean race out there.
Sounds great. That is Dylan Jones, your winner tonight here at Watkins Glen. Andy and Rick in the post-race booth down there, we saw a dandy of a race tonight and a domination by Mr. Jones. But all in all, a good, exciting, clean race.
Absolutely. I tell you what, Andy, I don't know about you, but had a heck of a time watching a few laps here. Got in here just a little late. Sorry, guys, but for what I saw, awesome racing out there. And just the sportsmanship is just something that needs to be recognized here. Just all around great guys out here racing, having a good time, and we see it from week to week.
Yeah, we do see it week to week, Rick. But wow, that's a tongue twister. That's got to make the guy yourself who runs this whole thing to, along with the help of your admins and stuff like that, that's got to make you smile when you have that kind of camaraderie between all these guys. Everybody's different. Everybody has different styles of driving. But for some reason, four nights, five nights a week, they can get together on here, race and have a good time, and for the most part, I never see any of the issues in between drivers. They all seem to get along or forgive each other pretty easily.
Tell you what, Andy, like you say, when I do see this camaraderie of folks here, it does make me have a big smile on my face. But I tell you what, everybody knows that this is their league, and we wouldn't have the effort that we've got if it wasn't for every driver putting in the 100% here that they do. And it is what it is because these guys have made it that way.
Oh, most definitely. And that's what makes it fun to be here. Makes it fun to broadcast these races. Cause even though they get along well and things like that, man, these guys, they're not afraid to stick the bumper to each other. But they also know that if they do it, they might get it back the next time. So, yeah, great job by these guys. We're now six races into the season, four more to go. Next week, these guys roll into Iowa, and far as I'm concerned, and I know Ben can vouch for this, I don't think we've seen a bad race at Iowa yet. So I'm pretty excited about next week's race, and I think these B Cup cars are going to put on a heck of a battle there.
Absolutely, and I look forward to seeing that race as well next week. And not quite sure, I tell you, it's any man's race from what I've seen. It's definitely going to be fun to sit back and see who's going to get that checkered flag.
Iowa is going to be extremely fun next week. Like you said, Andy, we have seen a countless amount of races there, and every single one of them has been fantastic. I can't wait. It's going to be fun. It was a great race here in Watkins Glen. Before we get the closing statements, we'll go ahead and run you through the final finishing results, the whole finishing results. Coming home with the win, Dylan Jones. Then Dave Washington was second. Eric Dalariva rounds out the top three. Kevin Graham was fourth. Fifth was William Roberts. TJ Graves, good run for him, was sixth. Mitchell Lennon can't quite get the road courses down. He finished seventh. Brad Spiedel, eighth. Series sponsor James Ross was ninth. Andy Reinling at the top 10 was Andy Carpenter in 10th.
That's right, Ben, 11th. Brian Lambert, and 12th was Roy Carpenter. 13th was Stephane Brunel. 14th was Marcus Miller. Rodney Kramer came in 15th. Brian Neff came in 16th. Brian Terry had a little struggle there. He finished 17th. 18th was Ronald Henry. James Gagne finished 19th. 20th was Chad Osborne. And checking out pretty early there was Robert Lawson. He blew a motor there in the opening lap. So that's the 21 cars that ran this race, man.
Out of the 21, 10 finished on the lead lap, which is pretty good here on a road course, especially on simulation like this. But as we get ready to head out of Watkins Glen tonight and in Iowa next week for the Powertek Power Solutions Nationwide Series, Rick, do you have any closing statements?
Hey, the only thing I could say is buckle up and drive safe.
Andy, closing statements as we head out of New York.
Exciting week next week with Chicago on the horizon and Michigan for the trucks and then, of course, these guys at Iowa. So big week coming up next week for Noble, and it's also coming down crunch time for a lot of these series for these guys with championship hopes to really put the hammer down now and get it done.
It is going to be a fun week next week. Before we head off, let me go ahead and remind you, IL starts their season back up over on Team Explosion TV. Remember to like Team Explosion TV on Facebook, follow them on Twitter, and check out NobleMotorsport.com. Get over there, get signed up for next season, and be on TV. But for Andy Kessler, Rick Donathan, and Sam Taylor, I'm Ben Kilcrease. This has been a production of Noble TV. We will see you next time here in the Powertek Power Solutions Nationwide Series from Iowa. Good night from Watkins Glen.
Hey, Court has been at TSTV for the running of the 2013 A Court Training Paints Championship Series. It's fixed setups on Monday nights in the most exciting IndyCar series of iRacing. Check us starting Monday, April 1st at 9 p.m. Eastern on TeamSplosionTV.com.